Welcome back to Urb’n Barz, the UK reaction channel that brings you the best UK and world reactions in hip-hop, rap, grime and urban music. Tonight, Arrdee has literally just dropped a Daily Duppy on the GRM Daily set. And I'm interested to see, after the tracks like 3am in Brighton, Oliver Twist and the Lemon Pepper track, I'm interested to see if he highlights anything on the heat he's been getting on the recent rumours that he's an industry plant. Guys, so let's see. So Arrdee and the Daily Duppy. Arrdee.
Straight.
169.
Hey, they don't wanna see you shine, cause they see you shine, but don't see you grind. I was 14 with weed in a line, car didn't have pee and I needed a dime. So told man them I wouldn't leave them, but I ain't never ever get there, got a team in the ride. Then I see set man creep on the slide, I don't need to remind them, I've been on their mind, still feeding the guys. Whenever I can, cause they been with me from the start. Know how it feels when you've been on your ass, can't believe they're labelling me as a plant. Got me conflicted, could that mean that they're seeing all they're seeing is art? Great, but trust me, you see what I want you to see. And you never saw me on the graph. Never saw Mum Z leaving the yard, cause we couldn't pay rent with a tear in her eye. Never saw me tell a network, get a set merc, but he didn't wanna see little guy. I was in Collie when I first met Vince, we were beefing, he argued with me all the time. Cause he told me that I could get big in the place I was in, couldn't see to the line. I was.
So, I was right. Arrdee has addressed the issue of being an industry plant. And basically, it's a good thing he has. So there's been a lot of rumours, a lot of things flying around, left, right and centre, left, right and Chelsea, you know what I'm saying? And yeah, there's been a lot of barbs that he's an industry plant. And he said in this rhyme here, so it's like since the age of 14, he's been working so hard with no money, no peas, nothing to show for it. But he's been laying the foundations for where he's going to be and where he's got to today. So if you think about it, he said he was networking in college, and that's where he met his manager and etc. So basically what Arrdee is saying is, yeah, it's many years of hard work. Because what is he now? Is he 19, 20? So it's like 4, 5, 6 years of hard work has got him to this stage, you know. So let's go, guys.
Tunnel vision, roll to the ships with the boys and I leave with a dozen women. Place in the game, are you fucking kidding? I had to tell Carl I was gonna kill it. He's my manager. I think it's because of the caliber. When I came in the scene, straight damager. I'm leaving no crumbs, I'm a scavenger. I wasn't bad enough, boys, I was rapping up. Anyone I'm in the room with, I have to be better than them. That's the mindset that I work with. I started working late, never wrap up at 10.
So there you go. And that same mindset, so I'll just use a football one, I can use a boxing one as well, you know what I'm saying? But that same mindset, you have people like David Beckham, you have people like Wayne Rooney, you have people like Cristiano Ronaldo. And one thing, I've been talking to a lot of people lately about stuff about why people succeed and why people, some people are better than others, etc. But the one common denominator is all of these guys, like and Floyd Mayweather, all of these guys work harder than the next man. So you look at them and say, yeah, they're talented, but it's not just talent. Talent is a lot. Yeah, but it's hard work, endeavor, motivation. Yeah, sacrifice. That's what makes someone great. So what Arrdee is saying is he's sacrificed since he was 14 years of age. You know, he's had hard times, but he's endeavored, he's persevered, and now he's where he needs to be and where he feels he's going to be at. And that's what a lot of people probably can't take or don't like or are not happy about, you know, because they look at Arrdee and think, well, you just came from nowhere. But if you look into the chronology of what he's said and what he's done, this is how he's got to be where he is today. From the age of 14, is, you know, then from the college days, etc., etc. But also he's been making moves and he's been making the master plan. He had a plan. You know, it's always good to have a plan, people, to get to where you want to be.
I was sleeping in the studio way before kudos, back don't need patting from them. That's why I laugh when I see that they're talking, as long as they're talking I'm happy and blessed. Yes, this ain't checkers, it's chess, I can't settle and rest. I rap better when vexed, so keep pissing me off and let's check how it gets.
So he's saying, whilst you guys are playing checkers, he's playing chess. He's making chess moves. Lennox Lewis, chess moves. And he's also said, yes, keep getting him vexed, keep getting him mad, because he's better when he's mad. Do you remember that chronology? What was that term? Hulk, when in the film with Loki, when they said to Hulk Hogan, how do you stay so calm? Sorry, not Hulk Hogan. They said to the Hulk, how do you stay so calm? And the Hulk said, it's because he's always angry. I love that line. So, you know, when they said to Hulk, how is it that you've remained calm? He goes, no, because I'm always angry. Yes.
Yes, this ain't checkers, it's chess. I'm one step in ahead, they can't step in my head. They can't pressure and test, cause I'm better than them, and I don't think they like it. The girl scrolls through my TikTok, is me, and then gets excited. You ain't gotta fear me, I ain't gonna wife it. I'm a no joining your piping, you want some Bonnie and Clyde shit. We in the same, get left in the mist. I was drifting a bit, no check I could give to my mom. Now I'm repping the bits. Lip. How they gonna call me a label boy? Cause I ain't man, I don't play with toys. Hear their noise cause I'm making noise. And you're pissed off, they don't wanna play your boy. But it falls back to that statement void. In a party, he stands in the corner. No source, and he can't draw none. How you gonna rap when you can't even talk up? I ain't one for the drama. I stay smiley, bro, stays behind me. And he's far from Marga. I still tell man, nah, bro, the dumb shit ain't worth it.
Dumb shit ain't worth it. But literally, Arrdee is just about his business, you know? Don't get in trouble, you know, don't get into all the drama and stuff.
The car to the top and the boys always scratch the surface. I was riding around in a stolen Skoda, pissed off that it weren't working. Four man deep and a few beanies with a steering fox and we kept on swerving. He got a weed, he got a white MB and he got a phone line twerking. Meanwhile, me, I'm just driving drunk with all the girls trying to try shit on. What, you can't see I'm driving, hun? She said I don't mind playing nice and fun. It was only right I flew in the car I was grinding from. Now in the night I ain't driving drunk. I thought my guy like driver come. Quickly slide to a 90s drop. I'm a sweet boy, I'll even vibe with mum when I'm into the yard. I ain't in for the long run, I'm in and I'm gone. Bless, yes, it's ain't checkers, it's chess. I can't settle and rest, I rap better when vexed. So keep pissing me off or let's check how it gets. Yes, it's ain't checkers, it's chess. I'm one step in ahead, they can't step in my head. They can't pressure and test cause I'm better than dead. Yes.
To do with them Arrdee dance moves. Arrdee.
Ah. Pain.
Just to make this. Just to make this.
The flip side of the coin.
Thanks, baby.
Look. So here's the part of it that ain't nobody talk about. You build your line and do your walkabout. And Liz ain't getting cash in, but she's catting, so she'll fork it out. No, I ain't cussing the hustle, I've come to talk about the flip side of the coin. I'm here to make a point, let's talk it out. You come from struggle when you're trapping out to fill your fridge, I get it. You feel like it weren't a choice, you had to deal with it. Lizzie got a story too, different kind of feeling. Liz could never really cope, so she's smoking booze. I'll take you back though, Lizzie's home with.
So he said, this is the flip side of the coin. So this is very interesting because what Arrdee is singing about, I believe, this girl Lizzie, she's the flip side of the coin. So all these guys into trap and stuff, talking about how much money they make, the cars, the glitz, the glamour, the jewelry, etc., etc. Have they even considered the other side? So Lizzie is the other side. Lizzie is the side, you know, that who buys off of them, who actually vibes off of them, and who actually dies off of them. You know what I'm saying? And this is what Arrdee is telling you guys. So listen up.
Cold. Both her parents, Lizzie, didn't know. An 8-year-old should have her mother at the minimum to hold. She got bullied out of school, so as she grew, she didn't go. She's on the road so young, and no one cares, so no one knows. Smoking skunk while her brain's developing. 11 and she's always high, her pain she couldn't settle with. Vulnerable little girl, but she fronted with her medicine. The only man she talks to is her dealer, and he meddles with her mental. Nothing in this world's coincidental. There's a reason why they call. As a trapper, you ain't.
Nothing in this world is coincidental. Arrdee is so true. Nothing in this world is coincidental. So I think what he's saying is, yeah, the guy that's hooked up with her as her dealer or whatever, that wasn't by coincidence. You know what I'm saying? None of this. We attract certain elements, certain auras, certain things at different times in our lives. Nothing is coincidental. I'm just going to rewind that, guys. That was deep.
Always high, her pain she couldn't settle with. Vulnerable little girl, but she fronted with her medicine. The only man she talks to is her dealer, and he meddles with her mental. Nothing in this world's coincidental.
Nothing in this world's coincidental. If you only take away one thing from this song, mate, that is it. Nothing in this world is coincidental.
Oh, there's a reason why they call. As a trapper, you ain't got a choice. Cool, are gonna answer if they want it. What's with all the noise? But Liz ain't got one either. Difference is though, Liz ain't got a voice. She's scared. Her mummy didn't love her and her daddy didn't care. And her foster parents beat her and fucked her. It isn't fair. In that place, emotions ain't gonna save you. So in the end, it made her numb. She was done. She's older now.
And Liz is more than just a stoner now. A Rizzler and a rock is all she's got. She's a lonely child, 15 years old. She's got a pal, she thinks knows her well. Met her on the road, she was homeless. She's the one that got her on it. And Lizzie saw it as a favour, Donnie saw it as a prophet. Me, I saw it as a self-fulfilling prophecy.
Oh my goodness. Come on. So one saw it as a favour. Her friend saw it as a favour. The dealer as a prophet. And Arrdee seen this as a self-fulfilling prophecy. It happens again and again and again and again. It's a case of history repeating itself. You know what I'm saying? These things happen all the time. It's like a loop, a cycle, a vicious circle, a never ending circle, a cycle of
You see, my city means a lot to me, but crackers ain't got access to nothing here but a rock they need. Lizzie's mate just got a home. The environment ain't safe for a girl who's 18 years old, but she ain't thinking that. She saw her mate slapping her veins and she was feeling sad, so Lizzie tried it too. She's on the beat now, watch her sinking that. The vandal stinks and Lizzie's life, she's on an inch of that. And as a trapper, you're focused on you, so you're just thinking cash. This came short of...
As a trapper, you're just focused on you, so you're just thinking cash. But on the flip side, what about all the Lizzies in this world?
I was furious, gave Liz a slap. I always do you deals. You take the piss, you better bring me that. She's sharing needles now, too afraid to call again. Isn't eating food, don't wash herself to live is torturing Liz. She started bugging on the road. All the runners took the piss, they filming her on Snapchat. And Liz is crying, but she's pissed out. She couldn't talk, but got her quipped out. Kitty gave her more, he took the score and then he dipped out. Liz is on the floor, she ain't walking to the crib now. The police called her a whore and said, there's kids about, you sick cow. You see a nitty, but to me I see a little girl who ain't deserved a life. She got zero chance and it's written well. She found a needle round, she fill it up, then flick it out. Everybody see her, but ignore her, they ain't looking down. She put a dodgy needle all under her skin, pushed it in and knew she fucked it up. Thinking this is it, this died petrified. You build your line in hopes to better life, I get it. But there's two sides to that coin, I have to emphasise. Arrdee, Daily Duppy, 3 p.m.
Wow. So we had two tracks there from Arrdee. The first track was in answer to all his detractors, all the critics, all the people saying he's an industry plant. I really liked what he was saying. I wasn't so hot with the music itself. Take it or leave it, you know what I'm saying? Second track. That was really interesting. I mean, I really like that. I really like that. That's a sort of, I mean, I grew up with hip hop from the 1980s, guys. I've been into hip hop for donkeys of years. And I grew up with that stuff from time, so I've grown up with every part, every conceivable sort of genre in hip-hop, whether you want to call it rap, whether you want to call it trip hop, whether you want to call it trap, whether you want to call it grime, whether you want to call it whatever. Trust me, but the storytelling is the most important part of any MC. And when I say MC, I'm not sort of rappers, I'm talking MCs, and I know a lot of MCs. Trust me. And yeah, that story that Arrdee told was something that we should really think. And it's all about, you know, are you a product of the environment or is it just something that's part of you? We don't know. But that story about the girl Lizzie, that really hit home. So yes, you've got the life of being a trap star, you know, sort of making money, driving cars, jewelry, women, blah, 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 blah. But has anyone ever thought about the other side of it, the people on the other side? Yes, I know what you're going to say. You're going to say it was their choice. But, well, yeah, okay. But sometimes we need to sit down and think. And Arrdee said two things to me that are going to sit with me for a long time. Nothing in this world is coincidental. That's something that we need to think about. Think about hard. And also, the second thing Arrdee said was it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. Fulfilling prophecy. History repeats itself, guys, and it's a vicious cycle going round and round. So yeah, I really, really like that second track. I liked the rhymes on it. I liked the music on it. I liked the actual theme of the track. I liked what it was saying. There's a lot of social consciousness going on in that track, and that's the sort of thing that really resonates with myself. So guys, Arrdee's come back strong and he's answered his critics, so it'd be interesting to see what the critics will respond. Like, is he an industry plant or is it just hard work and endeavor and talent on top of that? But there you go. So that was the Daily Duppy. That was our boy Arrdee from Brighton. I like his stuff. I've liked his stuff for a long time. 3 a.m. in Brighton was a good one. I liked his Lemon Pepper Cup. That was really good as well. Oliver Twist, that was really good with the violins, etc., etc., etc. I can't wait to hear the next Arrdee track. So guys, thank you very much for watching and listening. Please can you like, subscribe, and please share this with all your friends. So yeah, that was Arrdee. And that was the Daily Duppy. So guys, thank you very much for watching and listening. And please tune into the next Urb’n Barz. Have a great evening. Take care of yourselves. And thank you. Thank you. Thank you.